All right, so I am going live because I've had lots of questions from you guys about changing the way that we eat. So I'm a mom of two boys. Henry is 12, Milo is 10. And obviously I've been a health and fitness coach for almost 7 years now. So I've really been changing the way I eat. I've been changing the foods that are in our home. But over the last year, I've really started to notice that I just have kept foods in the house that honestly don't serve me or my family well. Good morning, you guys. How are you? And so I was listening to a podcast. As you know, if you followed me for very long, I have been focusing on healing my own gut because in the last year, I have definitely allowed COVID and the slowness of life and just, you know, being still a lot. I feel that time with eating and drinking things that honestly have not served my body well. And so I've had a lot of symptoms like weight gain, obviously, a lot of bloating that was driving me crazy, fatigue, you know, skin breakouts, all those things. And so for 17 days now, I've been working on myself, but not only have I just changed the way that I'm eating, I'm educating myself as well. I have been into clean eating for a long time. I understand the benefits of clean eating, but honestly, I've been diving deeper into what's actually happening inside our bodies and what does that mean long term. And so I was listening to a really good podcast by Gutsy Mom. You should follow her on Instagram. And she was talking about the fact that all the stuff that we're putting not only into our bodies, but especially our kids. Because you guys, like the foods that we have now, yeah, we had a lot of processed foods when I was a kid, but I feel like parents didn't just shove them at us like we do today, right? And so things that my kids love that I've kind of felt guilty about saying no to are things like potato chips. They love Fig Newtons, they love Oreos, they love ice cream, they love all the same things your kids love, right? And so while they do eat some pretty healthy foods throughout the day, I have really noticed we've gotten into a habit of just having a pantry filled with junk. And if it's here, that's what they're gonna reach for first, right? And so long term, what in the heck am I doing to my kids? You know, gut issues, you know, inflammation, you know, all the things that sugar and all these processed oils and all these things that are in these foods that we buy are setting them up for long term health problems. And so I was listening to this podcast and I was very convicted, very gutted, honestly, because I am a health and fitness coach and I've been letting my kids eat like crap. And so I just honestly, like I gave it to God and I really felt led to start making some changes for my kids too. So what is that going to look like? I am not going to be that like Nazi mom who just is like, you can't have anything ever, right? Because I don't believe in that. I don't believe in that mentality. I believe that 80, 90% of the food that we put into our bodies should be good, should be life-giving, but we can still allow ourselves to have the treats. So what I'm committing to for my family, and I've communicated this to the boys, they're not exactly like crazy about it, but I want to share a story that's a win for me. I've communicated that we're going to have less chips, pretty much almost no sugar in the house. Sugar is going to be saved for outside our home, for treats, for ice cream trips, for maybe a donut or something every now and then, but it's not going to be in our house because if it's in our house, they're going to reach for it. Instead, I'm going to replace those sugary things with things that are naturally sweet, like apples and peanut butter, yogurt with fruit and berries and nuts and even some dark chocolate chips. So I do keep dark chocolate chips. So last night, Henry, after our ball game, Henry would have normally come in and grabbed a bag of barbecue chips and eaten some sweets after that, right? So instead, I was like, hey, Henry, I bought you these yogurts and I can put some fruit and some chocolate chips on it. Do you want me to make you that? And he was kind of skeptical. He was like, yeah, I guess so. Put that on there. But he ate it and he kept saying, Mom, is this good for me? Like, what's in this? He started reading the label. And we don't talk calories and things like that in our house. But he started reading the label. He's like, it's got lots of protein. That's good for me, right? He was like, it doesn't have very much sugar. Wow. And he was like, this is good. Like, this is really good. And I was like, thank you, God. I needed that win. Just to be able to move forward. So I'm actually headed to Trader Joe's today and to Sam's Club, and I'm going to stock up on just some good alternatives. Good alternatives for them to snack on. They eat well at meals because I cook well at meals, but it's really the snacking that is more of a problem. So, gonna have lots of nuts, still gonna let them have popcorn, do the yogurt thing, do lots of fruits and healthy fats, but I'm on a mission. I'm on a mission not just to help myself, not just help you be healthier, but to absolutely make the health of my children a priority. And so I'm gonna be sharing lots more. If you have any thoughts or if you have any questions or if you have any concerns or fears around that yourself, like tell me. Like this is a place we can talk about it. I see my friend Claire is on and she was saying this yesterday whenever I was sharing that. She was like, you know, it's just something I wanna do, but I've been a little afraid to do because our kids can be resistant. They are resistant to change. They are resistant to healthy foods because we've given them so much of the other stuff. And I just believe it's my responsibility to not do that. It's my responsibility to love my body and lead by example, but also to educate them on how to love their body because they're going to grow up. They're going to struggle with weight. They're going to struggle with high cholesterol. My kids are. They're going to struggle with the things that come from putting bad food into our bodies. And I don't want to, you know, allow them to get to adulthood and then say, Mom, why'd you give us all that stuff? Because now I'm struggling, right? Okay, that's my story. If it encourages you, great. If you have questions, hit my inbox. If you're like, this doesn't apply to me, that's okay too. That's okay, okay? I love you. Have a good day. Happy Friday. I'll share my Trader Joe's haul though.